Amen. Truly, truly, Bwana tupandishe, tupande milima yote. Kwa imani tuweze kusimama. But today I don't want to talk about the mountain. Today I want to talk about the valley. The valley of decision. The valley of decision. In the book of Joel, chapter 3, verse 14. Joel, chapter 3, verse 14. The Bible says, multitudes and multitudes in the valley of decision, for the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. Multitudes and multitudes in the valley of decision, for the day of the Lord is near in the valley of decision. All of us, we like mountains, as we have sung. But as I've said, I want to talk about the valley. Because when we are talking about the valley speaks of tough moments, painful seasons, when you're going through hard times. The valley speaks of that. Because we know very well, when we can look at David in the book of Psalms 23, it is starts by speaking about the mountain, that the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures, abundance. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. Not only that, he leads my paths, my steps, in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. But now when you come to verse 4, it speaks of, though I go through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. As a child of God, there are times that will come and will go through the valley. You will go through tough times, difficult moments, painful seasons. Christianity, it is not only about lying down in green pastures and enjoying the still waters and enjoying being led in the path of righteousness. There comes a time that the Lord will allow you to go through a season of the valley. The valley. When we look at Ezekiel, in Ezekiel chapter 37, the Bible speaks of the hand of the Lord came upon me and he led me in the valley of dry bones. They were not only dry, but they were so much dry. The valley of the dry bones. It is the hand of the Lord that came upon Ezekiel and led him there. It is not the devil. It is God himself who led him there. That's what I'm telling you. There comes a time that you'll find yourself going through valleys. And in that valley, you are not alone. The Bible says that multitudes and multitudes in the valley of decision making. So when you are going, when you are in your season of going through the valley, the decisions that you make matters a lot. Matters a lot. As for David, he says that when I go through the valley of the shadow of death, I want you to see this. It is the valley of the shadow of death. Death is not there, but there is a shadow of death in that valley. You cannot die in that valley. No. God cannot allow you to die there. But the things that you're going through, they are speaking to you that you cannot make it. You can die in that place. They are trying to communicate to you that you cannot go to your next level. You cannot go to your destiny. You cannot possess your possession and inherit your inheritance. They try to speak to you that the Lord has forgotten you, that you are a cursed person because of the things that you are going through. But you know what? The decisions that you make, because as for David, we see him speaking to himself. He makes this decision of not seeing the shadow of death. But he speaks like this, that the Lord is with me. He made this decision that I will not fear no evil. We know very well that fear comes from the enemy, and fear, it is the opposite of faith. So David, in the valley of the shadow of death, he is speaking faith. He is saying that the Lord is with me. Even this valley, the Lord is with me. And not only that, his rod and his staff, they comfort me. Speaking of his word and his spirit, that they are comforting me. He is together with me. He has not left me. And because of that, David, God is enabling him to cross over to the other side, where there is a table in verse 5, that you prepare a table in the presence of my enemies. Do you know what? There is no way you can enjoy that table unless you go through that valley with the Lord being with you. Saints of God, as I have said, there will come a time, there will come seasons that will go through tough times, through difficult moments. In the book of Isaiah, Isaiah 43, verse 2, the Bible says that when you go through the waters, I'll be with you. When you go through the rivers, when you go through the fire, you will not be burnt. I will be with you. Not if, it is when. It is not the matter of if. No, it is when. Why? A time comes that you go through. A time comes that you go through that valley. But the decisions that you make when you are in that valley, they determine your outcome. They determine your outcome. I'm being reminded of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. These three Hebrew boys, they were going through their own valley. The valley of what? The valley of decision making. When they were told by the king that they should not bow to anything else, not even their God, but they were supposed to bow down to an idol. It was a valley of decision making, whether to obey the king or to worship the Lord their God. Do you know what? They could have decided that we will bow, but in our hearts, we will not bow. We'll pretend we are bowed, but in our hearts, we know that Jehovah is God. It was a matter of decision making in this valley. And you know what? In the book of Daniel, chapter 3, verse 17, the Bible says that they said that our God, whom we serve, look at their decision in this valley, that our God, whom we serve, he is well able to deliver us from this fire. And we know that he will. But even if he chooses not to deliver us, we will not bow. They are in the valley of decision making. And they make their decision very clearly. And they make a right decision that they will not bow. It is all about decision making. Why multitudes and multitudes in this valley of decision making, they are there. They were not the only boys, Hebrew boys. No. There were other people who were bowing in this valley of decision making. Look at Paul and Silas in the book of Acts chapter 16. When they were thrown in prison, this was a valley of decision making. Why are they in prison? What crime have they made? What have they done that is so wrong that they have been thrown in prison? Do you know what? The only thing that they had done, they had delivered a certain guy who was operating by the spirit of divination. And the Bible says that they were thrown in prison. But do you know what? In the book of Acts chapter 16 verse 20, the Bible says that at midnight, when they are in this valley, they say that they were praying and singing hymns. And you know what? They were not alone. The prisoners were listening. So in this valley, they were not alone. The prisoners were listening. These are people, it is true they are in jail, They are in this valley of prison, but they refuse to operate the way everybody else is operating. They had a reason. They could have argued, murmured, they could have complained that it is not by our own strength that we did what we did. No. But what do you see them doing? They are blessing the Lord. They are worshiping God. They are pleading God. They choose to see God even in this valley. That is their decision.
Hello.
That we shall see God in this valley that we are in. And you know what? You are not alone. Whatever you are going through right now, you are not alone there. Who speaks of multitudes and multitudes? Some prisoners are watching. You as a child of God, whatever you are going through, other people are going through, but they are watching you. The way you react, the way you behave, they are looking up to you. The Bible speaks over the soldier, the policeman who was guarding them. He came to them bowing down and saying, "What must I do that I can be saved?" Why? It was a valley of decision making. In this valley of decision making, we see salvation being seen in that prison. Sense of God, it is all about decision making in your own valley, what you are doing. The Bible speaks in the book of Psalms 34 verse 1, "I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth." When the Bible speaks that I will bless the Lord at all times, it speaks of, I will bless the Lord when I am in the mountain. I will also bless him when I am in the valley. At all times, his praise shall continually. I will bless the Lord. I will worship the Lord. I will uplift the Lord. I will exalt the Lord. Even when I am going through this valley. Why? He's together with me. Look at David in the book of Psalms 27, verse 13. He's saying, "I could have fainted." He is not in the mountain. He is in the valley. He said, "I could have fainted unless I believed to see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living." He is in his own valley. Even in Psalms 30 verse 5, when he's saying that weeping endures for a night, but joy comes in the morning. He's talking about his own valley. He's talking about his hard time, his difficult moments, what he's going through at that time. Multitudes and multitudes in this valley of decision making. Multitudes and multitudes. Many are there. What are you doing when you're going through your hard time? I'm being reminded of Joshua. In the book of Joshua, chapter 24, verse 15. Joshua and the children of Israel, they are in their own valley. And Joshua tells them like this, that if it seems evil for you to serve the Lord, choose today whom you shall serve, whether the gods of your fathers, the gods of the Egyptians, or the gods of the Amorites. But he says, "As for me, I made a decision that as for me and my family, we shall serve the Lord." In this valley of decision making, Joshua is telling them, "As for me, our purpose, as for me, I'm going all through. The Lord is my God. I'll continue trusting him. I'll continue depending on him. I'll continue leaning on him. I'll continue fixing my eyes on him." That is Joshua. He's saying, I will trust the Lord. Me and my family, we shall live according to his laws. We shall obey him. We shall allow him to guide us and to lead us. Hallelujah. The valley of decision making. Do you know what? God is not only God of the mountain. He's still the God of the valleys. In the book of 1 Kings, chapter 20, verse 28, the Bible says that God said to the children of Israel, "Because the Syrians have said that you have defeated them, because you are on the mountains, that I am the God of the mountains, but I'm not God of the hills, I'm not the God of the valleys. Today they will see. I will deliver you. I'll deliver them into your hands so that they may know I am also the God of the valleys." Do you know what? He's God of the valleys. He is not God when things are okay only. He is God. Even when things are not okay, he is God. Nothing can change him from being God. Look at David in the book of Psalms 121. He's saying, I will lift my eyes unto the hills. Where does my help come from? If he is lifting his eyes on the hills, he is in a valley. That's why he's saying, I will lift my eyes unto the hills. He is in a valley. Where does my help come from? And you know what? We have so many hills. You can lift your eyes on the hill of a job, the hill of a business, the hill of a marriage, the hill of your account, the hill of your background, the hill of your connections, the hill of your position. But you may find help, but it will be for a season. True help comes from the Lord. David is saying, I will lift my eyes unto the hills. Where does my help come from? Then he answers himself. He says that my help comes from the Lord, the creator of the heavens and the earth. That is David. As I've said, when you're going through your valley, God is with you. He's still God. The Bible speaks of many, many are the afflictions of the righteous. But God delivers him from them all. God, not few, many. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. Not sinners, but the righteous. Many are the afflictions of the righteous. But the Lord delivers him from them all. Sense of God, our God is a faithful God. In the book of James, chapter 1, as I conclude verse 2, we say that, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. When you fall, it means that you go to a valley. Count it all joy when you fall. When you are in that valley, knowing that the testing of your faith, it produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that may be complete, one, perfect, two, lacking nothing, three. Sense of God, as you go through that valley, the other side, there is a table prepared for you, so that you may enjoy. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you.